everybody. Let us continue to write palletizing programs. We had a pallet in which there were 24 positions. So we can write that palletizing program in a different way. So this diagram I'm going to redraw like this. There's the same number of rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, and same number of columns, 6 columns. So we need to place a part at every intersecting point of every row and column. So you'll have 24 intersecting parts, so 24 locations for placing the parts. Now a little extra data that is given to us, the objects to be picked up are 25 millimeter tall, okay, and the distance between the rows is 50 millimeter. Every row is away from the other row by 50 millimeter, and the distance between the columns is 40 millimeter. Okay, so to do this program, we are going to define 4 variables. One is called row, which indicates the row number. So row can be 1, 2, 3, 4. The other is called column, which indicates the column number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. X indicates an X coordinate value, okay, and Y indicates a Y coordinate value. Now there are some location constants that we are defining. The first location constant is pickup, which is the pickup point on the chute where the part is going to come. And the next location constant is corner. Corner is at the starting point. The first location where we have to place the first point, that is part that is called corner. So we are also going to define some location variables, which is called drop. So what does drop indicate? Where I want to put the part, that is called drop. So the first location where I want to place the part is called corner, and subsequently all these things are called drop points. So coming to the program palletize. Okay, so the first part of the program is to learn where the pickup point is. So by using this statement, we can learn the coordinates of the pickup point. So the robot learns the coordinate of the pickup point. Same way, when you can learn the coordinates or teach the robot the coordinates of the corner point. Okay, so these are our location constants, pickup and corner. So teach the robot the coordinates of the pickup and the corner point. Now we are having the location variable. So that is drop. What is drop? Coordinates of X, Y corresponding to each place, the intersection point of the row and column. So that's a variable. So as X and Y changes, this drop coordinates also keep changing. So continuing with the program, the first step in the program is, after defining all this, is open immediate. So open immediate, open I opens the immediately the gripper. So open immediate the gripper. So then we initialize the row variable to 0. So row is equal to 0. So initialize the row variable to 0. Then you have Y is equal to row into 50. So we had seen in the diagram that the gap between the rows is 50 mm. So now that we have row is equal to 0, then we have Y is equal to row into 50 means we are going to say Y is equal to 0. 0 into 50 is 0. So Y is equal to 0. So the next statement that comes is column is equal to 0. Initialize the column variable to 0. So then we compute the X variable as X is equal to column into 40. The gap between the columns, the distance between the columns is 40. So X is equal to column into 40. So now that is also 0. So drop is equal to corner plus 0 comma 0. So if you come to this diagram, where are we? We are at corner. The first place is corner. So corner plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 comma 0 is what corner itself. So we have defined the first drop location as the corner itself using this statement. Drop is equal to corner plus X comma Y means corner plus 0 comma 0, which is corner itself. Now we have to drop the part. So to drop the part in the first location, we first have to pick up the part. So you first approach, like in the previous palletizing program, you approach the chute. So don't approach it directly at the pickup point. Approach it above the pickup point, 50 units above the pickup point. Okay, so 50 millimeters above the pickup point, that is the chute. Then move in a straight line down to the pickup point. So when you move in a straight line down to the pickup point, you are actually reaching the where the part is. Then close immediate. So the gripper closes. After it closes, depart 50. So from the pickup point, go up 50. So here you are coming to the pickup point, but not to the pickup point, above it by 50. coming down to the pickup point, closing and picking up the part, departing above the pickup point by 50 units. So this is the pickup sequence. The next one is the drop sequence. So approach the drop point. Our drop point is now defined as the corner. So that's the first location. So approach the drop point, but not the drop point, above it by 50 units. Move down to the drop point, move in a straight line down to the drop point, open immediately. So when you open the gripper, the part that is there in the that is held by the gripper will drop down, drop onto that drop point, and then go above the drop point by 50 units. Okay, so the first part has come and it has been placed here. Now we want to place the next part. So for that, what we're going to do is we're going to fill one row completely. So I now have to go to this point, then I'll go to this point, then here, then here, then here. Once this row is completed, we go to the next row, fill this, 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 till that row is completed. Then we'll go to the third row, and then we'll go to the fourth row. So the program for that goes as follows. So increment the column by 1. So now you have gone to column which was 0, now becomes 1. Okay. So initially, if you see over here, you have initialized your column as 0. So column is equal to column plus 1. If column is less than 6, that is we have 6 columns. So we had started with column 0, 1, 2 like that. No. So if column is less than 6, go to 20. What is 20? 20 is compute. X is equal to column plus 40. Column into 40, sorry. Column is 1, so X is equal to 40. Okay. So we have moved in the X direction by 40 millimeters. So we have now reached here. Okay, now we say compute again. Drop is equal to corner plus x comma y. Y is still 0. We have not changed y. It's only x that has changed. So we have moved in the x direction by 40 millimeters. The corner plus 40 millimeters in the x direction takes me from 1 to 2. Okay, so I have come to this location. So what we do now? We keep continuing this. So after you update the drop point, you pick up sequence, drop sequence. The part is dropped at location 2. You keep continuing it till all the 6 locations on the first row are completed. So once that is completed, then we move to the second row. How do you go to the second row? The same way that we did for the column. Row is equal to row plus 1. If row is less than 4, because there are 4 rows, go to 10. Why less than? Because we are starting with 0. 0, 1, 2, 3. So less than 4, go to 10. So 10 says y is equal to row into 50. Now our row has become 1. So 1 into 50 means y becomes 50. Okay. Now column is equal to 0. X becomes column into 40, that is 0. So we now have got corner plus. We have incremented and we have got over here 0 and we have got over here 50. So what does that mean? We are going from here to here now. Okay. Corner plus. We have got to go here, corner plus 50 millimeters in this direction. So that is the way we go. So we keep repeating this till all the parts have been placed and we end the program. So the number of lines of code that you see in this program are 23, and the number of taught points are only pickup and corner 2. So it has reduced from 89 lines of code and 27 taught points to 23 lines of code and 2 points.